Yes, can I help you?
My name's Kim Hopper.
Kim Hopper. Oh, yes, we've been expecting you. You're the little girl that wants to see Star Trek, right?
Yes.
Well, it's quite a long ways away. Just take a bike right over there and make the right at the corner. It'll take you right there.
Thank you.
Okay, go ahead.
Aboard the Enterprise. Here, sit down in this chair. Does it look familiar? Eh? A little like Jimmy Saville's chair. I understand you wrote a letter to Jimmy asking him if he could fix it for you to come aboard the Enterprise and ask me some questions. Well, he did. Here you are. Welcome aboard. Fire away.
Before you started making Star Trek, was you interested in science fiction?
Yes. I did have an interest in science fiction before Star Trek. I read a lot of authors, and in fact, one of the thrills I had was those authors that I had read and really liked started to write for Star Trek, so I began to get to know them, various people, and they became friends of mine. So that was one of the thrills I had in working on Star Trek. I got to meet some of my favorite authors.
Did you ever feel that you were beginning to take on the personality of Captain Kirk?
Well, I began to order my kids around, but they still didn't listen to me. No, I've been a professional actor for many, many years. I was acting when I was 6 years old, and I was working on radio drama. Do you ever listen to it on the BBC?
Yes.
When I play a role professionally, I can go home and forget it because that's my work life, and then I have my private life, so one doesn't kind of get into the other.
Do you think, looking around now, that this could be the future? They'll probably be going places, you know.
I would think so. I know that the design of the ship was made very carefully, that people were engineers and space people were consulted about the design of the ship. So that there is a possibility that this is the kind of thing that it might be like someday in the future, yes.
Have you seen the Star Trek movie?
I've seen parts of it. We had to do what is called looping, which is when a noise or something that wasn't supposed to be on the soundtrack would be there while we were speaking. We have to go into a studio and repeat the words, repeat the line to the image up on the screen, so that if I said, Kim, I love you, that's just an example, Kim, and say somebody did something like that while in the background, and we didn't want that noise there, then I'd have to go into the studio and look at myself on the screen and say, Kim, I love you, all that, until I could match it, synchronize my voice to my lips. So I've seen some parts of it. In fact, I've got a special thing for you. for having written Jimmy Saville. We're going to fix it so that you can see some excerpts from Star Trek, the motion picture. Would you like that? You sure?
Yes.
A lot?
Yes.
Okay. Off we go.
Wormhole. Get us back an impulse power. Full reverse. Negative down control, Captain. Going reverse on impulse power.
Subspace frequencies jammed, sir. Wormhole effect.
Negative control. Inertial lag will continue 22.5 seconds before forward velocity slows to sublight speed.
Unidentified small object has been pulled into a wormhole with us, Captain, directly ahead.
Crossfans up, pull.
Wormhole distortion has overloaded the main power systems.
Will the manual override on help? No manual response, sir.
Navigation and deflectors inoperative, Captain. Direction control also inoperative.
Time to impact.
20 seconds.
Let's check off. Stand by on phasers.
No. Belay that phaser order. Arm photon torpedoes.
Object is an asteroid.
Target the asteroid.
Impact in 8 seconds.
Fire torpedoes.